Hello and welcome to this short video on the basic tissues and an introduction to histology. Histology is a microanatomy study. It's a study of the anatomy in a microscopic scale. So histology can be understood much better if you know the four basic tissues. So any question on any slide in histology will have a hint on an understanding of these four basic tissues. The first basic tissue that you need to know is the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue means it is a tissue that covers structures or it lines surfaces. For example, this is my skin, so it covers the skin. Epithelium is something that covers the skin. But you can also consider the oral cavity or the cavity of the esophagus or the cavity of the stomach. So inside that cavity, this epithelium will be lining. So on a basic idea, you need to understand that epithelial tissue is something that will be covering or will be lining surfaces. The next is connective tissue. What is connective tissue? Connective tissue is something that connects, as the word says. But the better term for connective tissue is supporting tissue. Supporting tissue is not only a mechanical support, though we intuitively think that connective tissue is something that connects structures mechanically, it provides a structural support, but it is also giving a metabolic support for the tissues that are around it. So connective tissue is extremely important in that sort. So the next is the muscular tissue. As you most of you know, muscles are concerned with contraction and muscles cause movement. So the specific array of certain proteins, contractile proteins like actin and myosin, makes this tissue as a specialist tissue that enables contraction in our body. And the next is called the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue has the quality of integrating, of getting stimuli or forming electrical stimuli or chemical and electrical stimuli and integrating it and conveying it. So it is basically involved in coordination of signals, coordination of activity. So these four basic tissues have specific activities, specific functions. Epithelial tissue is broadly, it has a function of a barrier. Connective tissue is basically supporting metabolically or structurally. Muscular tissue is basically causing movement, and nervous tissue is basically coordinating. The beauty of knowing these four tissues is that if you understand these four tissues, you can understand every slides of histology that you are going to learn. And every slides of histology that you will be learning will be having a particular proportion of this. Some part of that tissue will be epithelium, some part will be connective tissue, some part will be muscle tissue, some part will be nervous tissue. Some will have a high proportion of nervous tissue, some will have an absence of muscular tissue. So there are basically different combinations of proportions of these tissues in any slides that you take. To make it more clear, I've taken two representative slides. This is a slide of a fallopian tube, which we'll learn in detail later. So in this fallopian tube, this is the lumen of that fallopian tube. And what you're seeing here are all mucosal folds. So when you learn fallopian tube, you will understand that this is basically epithelium. And inside that you have a core of connective tissue. And here you have muscle tissue, and you may have a couple of few nervelets over here, which will cause contraction of these muscles. So here again, you can see the combination of these four basic tissues. So if you know the basic tissue, you clearly understand, you clearly split up any slides and you tend to understand it. Now this is another basic tissue. This is another tissue here. What you're seeing here is a spinal cord. Why I say this is a spinal cord, because you can see an H-shaped, this is an H-shaped gray matter, and this is a more paler white matter around it. Okay, that is a typical arrangement of a cross-section of a spinal cord. If you take spinal cord contains mostly nervous tissue. All this is nervous tissue. There's a little bit of connective tissue over here. This is dura mater, this will be pia mater, this will be arachnoid, so that will be connective tissue. Muscle tissue can be very, very less, unless you can have a few blood vessels over here, and around that blood vessels, you can have a little bit of smooth muscles. That will be the amount of muscle tissue that you find here. Epithelial tissue, yes, inside here, you have a central canal, which will have an ependymal cells. That is a modification of an epithelial cell. So here again, you can see a different proportion of different basic tissues. And, you know, spinal cord is mostly nervous tissue, but you also have a little bit of connective tissue, a little bit of muscle tissue, and a little bit of epithelial tissue. So basically, any slide that you take will have the combinations of these four slides and these four basic tissues. And knowing basic tissues will give you a big lead on understanding histology. Now, as you know, in all these pictures, it's basically a combination of two colors. One is pink and the next is blue. And often, most of the students get really frustrated when they learn histology because everything is looking pink and blue and everything is looking similar. But if you basically understand the theory behind it and you split up any slides that you see, split into components and you learn each of this, histology is going to be fun and really really giving you an edge when you learn the important subject called pathology, which is the basis of diseases. So histopathology becomes very, very fun to learn if you understand histology. So two colors that you learn here as pink and blue, and pink you will be called by the name eosin, and the blue will be known by the name hematoxylin. Now, what are these two esoteric names? Eosin is a dye, hematoxylin is also a dye. So these two dyes are used to paint, okay, literally they will be painting subcomponents of this tissue. So for example, here you are seeing these parts as pink, and these parts you can see a lot more bluish parts. Okay, so basically blue will be taken by nuclei. Okay, blue will be taken by nuclei, and pink will be taken basically by the cytoplasm. So this is the basic understanding that you need to know. Now there are some small exceptions that I'll come to that later, but for the as a general rule, you can learn that nuclei will be taking a blue stain or a hematoxylin stain, cytoplasm will be taking an eosin stain or a pink stain. And if you are learning in India, you might be familiar with these two pencils. Pink pencil is the eosin pencil, which you'll be using to shade. When you draw a histology diagram, you'll be shading the cytoplasm and the cell membrane with the eosin pencil. And the nuclei, you will put the nuclei dots using the hematoxylin pencil. Okay, so these two are the dyes that are used to stain, to differentially stain the subcomponents of a histology slide. And with this, we will understand histology slides in detail. So that is about a short introduction and the basic tissues. So the take-home point is you need to learn the four basic tissue: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and nervous tissue. You will learn each of these basic tissues in detail in the upcoming videos. Thank you so much.